just left for the middle of the woods. And here we are at this abandoned house.
Yo, what is up, explorers? So, this is insane. I am actually really, really excited. I haven't been this pumped up for an explore in a little while, honestly. So let me give you a quick rundown into history. This is an abandoned house right here next to me. This house was owned by an Ivy League professor. Yeah, Ivy League. He was a professor in biochemistry at one of the really top schools in the country. Like, everybody wants to go to the school specifically for anything relating to science and business, things like that. This is a very, very reputable school, and this guy makes $500,000 being a professor at this school. Like I said, he teaches biochemistry. Before buying this house, like years before buying this house, he actually studied chemistry and biology in Japan and then came here and basically made a life here. He bought this house, he married his wife, and he had two kids. He had a daughter and he had a son. I don't have exact dates on a lot of the things that the family did personally. All I know is that the daughter actually studied at the same school that her dad is a professor at. She ended up taking business and is now like a head marketer or something like that. And now on to the sadder parts of the history. I really don't like these parts of the story, but you know, not everything has a happy ending. So basically his son ended up getting charged with sexual charges, and he's in jail now. And the wife, his wife actually died in 2002. So, as far as we know, this house has been abandoned since 2002, maybe even earlier. The family just picked up and left after the wife died. Everything is still left behind inside this house, like everything. It's basically been sitting here as if it's a time capsule from the 90s, maybe even the 80s. But yeah, guys, so we're gonna go inside, we're gonna explore, and we're gonna see what we can find and investigate. So let's go. Know I'm here with Exploring with Josh. I'm here with Exploring with Danny. We also have two other friends inside the house already. They're just photographers taking pictures, but let's check out what's around us right now. Literally, this is just his garden right here. He had a huge yard. I mean, for an old house, he had a lot of land. I wonder what they were making in the garden here. I mean, maybe they had their own produce and vegetables and fruits and stuff like that, and now it's just a barren wasteland. I mean, there's really nothing growing right here. It looks like they had a little area for a tree to grow. That's usually how people grow trees. They try to support it from the bottom with those little things right there. He has a really big shed right here too. Oh, would you look at that? It's Josh.
Yo. Go upstairs.
Upstairs in the shed?
Yeah, we didn't miss that.
Okay. So, let's see here. You can tell he's got a lot of, like, landscaping equipment and stuff. Lawnmower. Josh said let's go upstairs, so let me just look. Oh, man. That's insane. Guys, he has a huge canoe right here. Oh, my goodness, that's insane. That's super cool. I didn't know that. That's massive too. All right, let's get back down and then we can go inside the house. Under the trees. Walking up to the house. You can tell that for the time, this was a big house. Not a lot of people used to own houses like this back in the 80s and the 90s. This is a very big house. And right here he has a basketball net and a very tiny court right here in his driveway. Obviously just for his two kids. House is actually really, like, preserved. It's in really good condition for the time. Keep in mind, I said that this place has been abandoned since at least 2002, maybe even the early 1990s. So, I mean, it could have been two decades at the most. All right, let's go inside. Not much in this one room, but this is the actual house right here in front of us. So guys, right off the bat, this is the first room that we walk into when you go in through that door, and we're already finding stuff. I mean, the dude's shoes are right here, there's a baby picture right here. I don't know who that is, it might be one of his kids, but we're not sure.
And this is actually his United States passport. So this right here is very sensitive information. I'm obviously gonna blur his face and his name and his signature. So just for proof that this is him, I mean, that's his US passport and it is what it is. Right here you can see that he's got a stamp that goes from New York to Japan. So that's probably when he was, you know, traveling and studying biochemistry or whatever. There's also two stamps in there for New York and one for California. That's insane. I dig the Dunkin' Donuts thermos too. That's cool.
That's a big one. You're gonna be addicted to have that.
Seriously, he must have addiction like me. Going through the dude, look at this. He still has his pants and jackets just hung up on the hook, dude. That's so crazy. Like, this has been sitting here for like 2 decades. Oh my god. Yo, what the hell? This just gets better and better. Blazer, jacket, some kind of cover-up on the table. Silverware, the old-fashioned salt and pepper shakers, and an old dial phone. This fireplace is massive too. And in here, it just looks like they have some silverware, some containers and knickknacks, stuff like that. Crazy. Paint chipping on the walls. You know that this place has lead paint. It's a very old house. Look at that chair. Who would sit in that chair besides like a toddler? I mean, I might be able to fit in there. I'm a skinny dude. Oh my god, this is crazy. Look at this. I'm gonna blur these faces out, but those are the kids. The daughter is on the right and the son is on the left. Obviously when they were babies, that's when this picture was taken. Some trophies right here. And some really old silverware that's starting to mold. Pictures of people right there. Maybe a whole family portrait. This right here, this is actually, is this mail? Yeah, it is. This is unopened mail, just sitting there. More kid pictures right there. This is insane. Look at the carpet on the stairs. It's still here. We'll head upstairs after we do the first floor. We have to make sure we stay organized. Oh my god. Yo, I am freaking out right now. This house is just insanely stacked with stuff. The furniture. Oh my god, what is this? Oh, I know what this is. This is, these are slides that go into a projector. That's insane. I don't even know what's on the slides, though. Can I see, though? I don't think so. No, I can't really see it from, like, right now. I think I have to actually be on the projector and show it. Yeah, I can't see anything, but that's insane. Imagine what could be on there. The history, the personal family history that could be right there on those slides, and we'll never know. Because we don't take anything from these buildings. We just come here, we document, and we just keep the memory of these places alive while creating art, and we're very respectful to our surroundings. This is a beautiful scene right here. The old rocking chair, the wooden rocking chair at that, and a really old piano that I doubt works anymore. It almost feels like an organ, but yeah, it doesn't work. I'm just amazed at all of this right now. Fireplace is massive again. I wonder who painted this picture of the mountains, the fields. I don't even know what this is in this jar. Could be alcohol. Could be pee. You never know. Oh my god, look in the closet. There's even more. Even more of those slides right there. Let's move that. This one's almost completely full. Look at that. Wow. And there's a letter right there. You can see there's writing. What else is in here? Some ropes and harnesses. What's this bottle say? Smashed, but mead, B B&W Mead, December 3rd, 1983. That's what was in here. That's probably what's in here, too. Wow, okay.
Dude, I just saw you touch the painting, and it reminded me that I didn't actually say anything about the painting, so I have to say something now. I wonder who that is. It could have been the wife, or it could have been the daughter. We don't know.
Actually, that is a really good question.
Another weird thing about this is that the paint is actually starting to chip off of the canvas. It's weird. That's how long this has been sitting here, just like literally collecting dust and just decaying.
All right, going through this narrow hallway right here. Let's see. What's happening? What is this? Is this? I don't know what this could be, but we're gonna keep looking. I hear Danny's voice. Is that exploring with Danny?
No, it's exploring with Fanny.
Oh, man.
This looks like it was another living room. That's what it seems like to me. I cannot believe how much furniture is just left here in this house. Like, everything is still here, guys. It's just blowing my mind. Really old speaker. That looks like something I saw back in, like, elementary school. Because I went to a really old-fashioned elementary school. Let's see. What is in the mystery box? Is there a ray gun in here? Like, am I going to see something? Nope. No ray gun. But there's a bunch of books. Sometimes knowledge is better than a ray gun. Maybe. You guys want to know how long this house has been untouched? The clicker is still on the couch. This was probably Dad's seat. Like, you know how in every family, like, everybody has their own assigned seat in the living room? I mean, maybe that's just my family, but the clicker is still there. So that makes me think he would probably chill right there. And he would put his feet up on the little thing right here.
The clicker.
The clicker. That just makes me think that he was chilling there. And I don't know. The TV's right here. So, I mean, he probably just hung out here with his family. I wonder why they had two living rooms, though. That's weird. Fireplace is massive and it still has logs inside the little container, inside the cage. Here's a photo right here. Oh, wow. I don't know who that is. Nothing written on the back. Huh. To the second floor we go. I don't know if I've said it already, but this is one of my favorite houses, or favorite abandoned places in general, but definitely one of my favorite abandoned houses that I've ever been to. This, like, ticks all of the boxes for me personally. It's got history, it's got stuff in it. So we can either go in there or we can go in here. I think I'm gonna go in here. By the way, guys, this is Casey visiting us from Baltimore. And we got Izzy, who you guys haven't seen in a while, probably since the summer of 2019. This is insane. I can't, this is probably my favorite thing right here, is the charcoal drawing right here.
Look under it. I like these.
Under it?
Yeah.
Oh my god. All right, so I'll be blurring that out, but...
And these are all classic books. Like, these are, like, books that you would read in high school. Like, literally every single one. The Canterbury Tales,
oh,
Alice
yeah.
in Wonderland.
I've read the Canterbury Tales.
Yeah. It's pretty dope.
This is Alice Stuart in Little. Wonderland. Oh, I love Stuart Little.
But these are, like, original. Like,
yeah.
Like, let's see.
There's a letter right here.
1973. Printed in USA.
Wow. That's insane. The amount of vintage and just old stuff in this house is crazy. I'm blown away at all the stuff that's in here. Like this old chair. I don't know whose bedroom this could have been.
I'm surprised that the bed is still, like, in such good condition. I mean, guys, nobody has explored this place in years. This is, some kind of Japanese book. I don't know how to read Japanese, so, like, I don't know what it is. But we're gonna open it. We're gonna check it out and just see. Yeah, see, this is definitely Japanese, because you can only read it up and down. Another fireplace. That's three or four that I think I've found so far.
This book was printed in USA.
So you're saying that...
So this must have been the mother right here?
Of the old, like...
The daughter or the son?
Yeah, like, these are all books you've...
And then right next to it is some kind of, like, knitted canvas painting. Well, not even a painting, it's like... I don't know, stitched.
Canterbury Tales.
That's cool.
That's actually really cool.
We're gonna cut through this way. Look at all their linen, bed sheets, and comforters. There's ribbons from 1997 right here. It's just everything, dude. Let's see. I'm gonna go this way so I can just get away from the noise for a couple minutes. So, let's see here. This room is like, I don't know. Oh, that's creepy. I caught it before it was on camera, but look at that picture. I don't know if that's the wife or the daughter, but they're just chilling in a black and white photo, probably on super 8mm film, in the dining room. A suitcase, nothing inside. Another fireplace. It's like there's a fireplace in every room. So apparently the attic is right there, but Izzy just told me that there's literally nothing but rat poop, and it's disgusting up there. There's nothing up there, so we're not even gonna bother. Which is cool, because the attic is usually the scariest part in any place. You know, they're in every room that I want to be in. I need silence to film. I can't hear myself think or talk, so... Alright, let's start in this room. Alright, alright. We're gonna blur that out right there, because that's nudity, and we don't do that on this channel. This is insane. I'm pretty sure there's a bunch of letters left in here. Yeah, there is, look. So, I'm just, like, reading the letters and stuff. Basically, the daughter had a love life, as most daughters do, as most children do. And she had a lover, I guess, that was from Pennsylvania? I don't know. That's a whole box full of... letters and love letters. Let's, like...
This is, like, supposedly the best letter.
Let's see here.
Oh, but you're gonna blur out.
Yeah, I'll blur everything out. Just to be sure. I can't be giving the locations away. The best letter. It literally says the best letter on the envelope. So it's like the daughter...
And these are all from her lover. This whole box.
You guys can't read from that far away, but look at this. This guy wrote pages to this chick. It's insane. He really did love her. I hope that they're together now. August 25th, 1987, guys. P.S. Write back soon and start your story. I love you. Why can't we be like that nowadays? Why can't we go back to writing letters to the people we like and love? By the way, guys, just so you know, I'm obviously putting all the letters back in the original envelope, and I'm just putting them back in the box that I found it in. You know how it is. We don't touch anything. Well, we do, but if we do, we put it back. I don't know if anybody knows what that means, but if you have a penny taped to your envelope, just let me know in the comments below. I mean, that
maybe
might
it's
mean
like a,
something.
Maybe it's like a good luck penny.
Maybe, yeah. And you know these are old too, because they're all written in cursive. Like, this is dating back to when cursive was like the only form of writing that was acceptable. You, once again, looked absolutely stunning. Yo, I can't read the rest of these. I'm gonna start crying. Alright guys, so I'm gonna head on into the rest of the house. We've been sitting here for maybe like 15 minutes just going 82. Through. 82? Wow. We've been sitting here for a while just like going through all of the letters. I mean, there's gotta be hundreds. Thank you. last room in the house. So, if I had to use common sense, I would say that this room was probably the dad's study. And by that, if you don't know what a study is, it's basically a place where somebody has a specific room in their house that is dedicated to doing work, reading, stuff like that. Anything that you need to get away and isolate yourself for, you go to your study and you just do what you gotta do. Ice skates on his chair. Photos of people. We're gonna blur those, obviously. This guy was definitely an academic. You can just tell by all the kinds of books that he has. Biology, chemistry. So many CDs. Flat World? Maybe. There's like CDs here. There's a ton of CDs about the world is flat, flat world. Maybe he was one of those flat earther people. Not saying that, that's wrong, but it's not the smartest philosophy.
You got stupid white men, the myth of monogamy, the cheating culture.
Yeah, boy! See, this doctor knew what he was doing. Good stuff.
Alright, explorers. So, we explored this entire house. I mean, all that's left for me to do right now is to get my B-roll shots, and then that's it. We're gonna pack up and get out of here, because it gets dark in like an hour. But, quick thing about the house, we've definitely come to the conclusion that I think the professor died. Because, I mean, there's really no reason that all of this stuff is just here, and no one's come back to fix it. I mean, I told you guys about the sexual charges on the son. We know that the wife definitely died inside the house. The only sole surviving member of the family really is the daughter. Like, she's the only functioning member.
I was thinking that, but the other thing I thought about was, why does the daughter not come back for any of this stuff?
Right. I think she probably did for most of her stuff, and everything else she just left.
But the love letters and stuff, you don't think that's important to her?
She probably has a husband by
now. I'll stop
it now.
It looks like it means a lot. You have to write it down, you know what I mean?
I don't know.
You never know. I mean, these places always have so much mystery to it, and that's mainly why we do it. We love the thrill of just delving into things that we don't know about and having to put the pieces of the puzzle together and just come up with a story. And hopefully our story's accurate. So, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button, smash the subscribe button, come and join this family that I got going on. And make sure you go and subscribe to the homies too. Josh, Danny, Casey, Izzy, all links are in the description below. And be yourself and go explore the world. Peace.
Peace.